some of the claims that the first affirmative speaker just said. While going on to the first affirmative claim, the speaker says that the income from the brothels would bring money to the economy. And then one of these ways they said that this would come about, it would result in $120 million that we spend trying to control it. We would be saving that money if we legalized these brothels. And then we could also tax these brothels to make more money. And then so according to National Priorities Project, in fiscal year 2015, federal government is projected to spend around $3.9 trillion. These trillions of dollars make up a considerable chunk, around 21% of the US economy, as measured by the gross domestic product. That means that the government spending makes up a sizable share of all money spent in the United States each year. And according to the government department of the United States, total federal government debt in 2015 at the end of the fiscal year was coming out to $18.63 trillion. And so with some of that tax money is going towards, 42.2 cents of every income tax dollar is going to the military. 10.2 cents of every income tax dollar is going to the interest of non-military debt. So that's already over half of the every income tax dollar is going to the military. And if we would legalize these brothels, the prostitutes, the brothels that exist in Nevada already, according to the Business Insider, the prostitutes split their earnings with every brothel owner. So already half of what they make is given to the brothel owner. And also, if the customer takes a taxi to the establishment, drivers will also get 30% of the transaction will be deducted from the prostitute's pay. So, and most of these sex workers are considered independent contractors and don't receive unemployment, retirement, or healthcare benefits. Commercial sex workers are considered independent contractors and must register with the county sheriff. In the city of Winnemucca, sex workers must register their vehicles with the local police, and in some cases, they aren't even able to get cars at all. So from a sex worker's point of view, they're getting half of their earnings to the brothel owner, and even a percentage to the customer if they travel by taxi, and that's according to the brothels that already exist that are legalized. And so they're also getting taxed, and they're also, the majority of them are from the lower class. So from the sex workers' point of view, I don't think legalizing the brothel would attract more sex workers to come work there. Instead, I think they would just stick to their underground roles of the prostitution that's not legalized yet. Moving on to the second claim that the affirmative speaker said, he said that the children, that there's children being forced into illegal prostitution. Well, legalization of prostitution and decriminalization of the sex industry actually increases child prostitution. Areas where prostitution has been legalized in the past has proved this. For instance, in the Netherlands, after legalization of prostitution, child prostitution increased dramatically during the 1990s. And the Amsterdam-based child rights organization estimates that the number of children prostitution has increased more than 300% between 1996 and 2001. And also, child prostitution has increased dramatically in the state of Victoria compared to other Australian states where prostitution had not been legalized. So of all the states and territories, the highest number of reported incidents of child prostitution came from Victoria, and this is coming from the areas where the brothels are legalized. And then moving on to the second subpoint of his second claim, he said that people are being involved in human trafficking. While legalized or decriminalization prostitution industries are one of the root causes of sex trafficking. Actually, one argument for legalizing prostitution in the Netherlands was that legalization would help end the exploitation of desperate immigrant women who have been trafficked there for prostitution. However, one report found that 80% of women in the brothels of the Netherlands were trafficked from other countries. Actually, legalization and decriminalization of prostitution is a gift to the pimps, traffickers and the sex industry. And so prostitution creates a setting, well, according to procon.org headlines, the prostitution world creates a setting where crimes against men, women, and children become a commercial enterprise. It is assault when he, she forces a prostitute to engage in sadomasochistic sex scenes. When a pimp compels a prostitute to submit their sexual demands as a condition of unemployment, it is exploitation and sexual harassment or rape. And these are all acts based on the prostitute's compliance rather than the consent. So moving on to the third point, when the former speaker says that it would protect the right of people, it actually doesn't, because legalization and decriminalization of prostitution does not enhance women's choice. So they don't have a right to their own body, because most women in prostitution did not make a rational choice to enter the business. They did not sit down one day and decide they wanted to become a sex worker. Instead, their options were more in the realm of how to feed themselves and to survive if they have families also. So these choices are actually better termed survival strategies rather than a choice. The data on human trafficking is sparse, but what is known is terrifying. It's already the second largest criminal industry in the world, so behind the trade in drugs, it's growing fast. And the global commercial sex trade exploits 1 million children annually, at least 100,000, and perhaps as many as 300,000 children in America are victims of sex trafficking each year. So about 80% of women in prostitution have been a victim of rape, according to prostitution research and education. So as you can see, this was, they are victimized. Other studies report that 68% to over 70% of women in the prostitution industry are being raped, and 85% of prostitutes are raped by their own pimps, and with an average of 16 times per year.